Good evening, everyone. How are you all doing? I thought I would cover a wee couple of solos by Dire Straits tonight. The Sultans of Swing Solos were two of the very first things that I first heard that really, really made me want to pick up a guitar and actually give it a bash. These are really well worked out solos. It's something a wee bit different this week. We get to ditch the pick and play on a clean tone for a wee while so we can brush off the muscles in the right hand and get them kind of doing some work for once. But the, like I was saying, these are really well constructed, really well worked out solos, and it really kind of highlights the idea of playing nice melodic phrases over the chords that are happening underneath. So we'll dive right into the very first solo. So the first solo starts over, we're playing over the verse chords for the first solo. Anyway, so it's round about those, just the first couple that we need to care about. So we start off with this bend on the 12th fret on the G string. And then we repick that bend a couple of times. And that's right over the A chord there, so you've got the... There's your A. So the solo moves down to a note that's bang on in that chord. Starts off in D minor. And then we've got an A major arpeggio that we climb up here because we're still hanging about on that chord for a wee minute. The A major arpeggio is played. The first two notes in this are played with, I am 100% sure these are harmonics. The first two notes in the low E and A string. And then you go into the 11th fret. D string, 9th fret, G string, 10th fret, B string, and 9th fret, high E string, and a wee bend of a half step on the high E string. So that our A major arpeggio starts with like this. Now she's back on the D minor chord by playing straight back down the D minor chord, the D minor arpeggio. So that's a wee hammer from the G sharp to that A there. So and then we move into the F. And we've got this cool wee lick here, bends from the G string on the 12th fret up to the 14th. And then repick the bend and pull it back down. So what was happening there, you're taking this note G, and you're bending it up to the A note, and you're playing these barred notes with the pinky. So this pinky's flattened over the B and E string there. And while this is bent, you're keeping those all squeezed in. And it's kind of, you're bending into this chord here. So that's... So you're actually playing an F major triad there. That's what you're essentially doing, you're sliding in, but with the bend. So And then it goes to C major. Well, lovely, just playing straight down a C major arpeggio. You've got the added F in there, though. There's your C major arpeggio there, and a sweet D shape. And at the B flat chord. Bend it up to the third of that. Yeah. Then you move into these chords. So over that part here, you just arpeggiate the chord. With a wee pull off on the 6th fret of the B string. That's your back to the D minor. Kind of riff there. The second solo is a bit more kind of technically demanding. There's a couple of kind of weird techniques, and whether you learn the techniques to kind of play this solo with or not is not really the point. They're worth just stealing because they're ideal wee techniques that you can throw in any solo or in any of your own bits of playing. So I'll talk you through the solo pretty quickly. We're still in D minor. I'm starting off with the same bend as we did in the first solo, but it's a bit more of a melody attached to it. So you're playing basically just a straight D minor arpeggio. Then we're going to do some pull-offs down the neck. Between 9 and 10, just a wee quick flurry of notes between 9, 10, 9, 7, 9, 7, 5, 7, 5. Then move on to the D string, 5, 7, 5, A string, 5, 7, 5, and the A string, I'm sure there's a wee kind of sneaky one, and on there as well. So that wee section goes. And then you've got a cool wee lick here. Now that wee lick is all in the right hand here. I've got a blister now because I've been playing this for the last hour or so. Yeah, I've got a blister on my thumb, so it keeps getting caught in the strings. But it's all in this percussive. You're trying to kind of get that noise that bass players get. I can't do slap bass or slap guitar, so, but it's that kind of thing. And I'm getting that with the thumb down, index up on the same string. And then the next note there is played with the thumb on a down strum. Pull off between the 8 and 10. 9, 8, 9, 7. Kind of there. And then you get a cool wee lick. This is worth kind of stealing and kind of try to pull into your own ideas. It's just a wee kind of C major. The top end of a C major chord at the 8th fret, or the 10th fret, or 8th fret, whatever one you want to go with. But we're using just these two fingers here. And what I'm doing there is I'm picking the top, I'm holding this wee kind of half F shape down at the 8th fret, 8, 8, 8, 9. And I'm picking the top one with my index finger. I'm not picking anything on the B string, I'm just hammering that with the pinky and pulling off. And then I'm playing the thumb on the lowest note there. And I'm just grouping that in groups of four, so it's going from 1, 2, 3, 4. It gives a nice kind of rolling effect because all the notes get to kind of blend in with each other. Then we move back to this kind of D minor chord and move back to the D minor pentatonic. We've got quite a kind of fast flurry of notes here, which is quite kind of tricky without a pick. But I'll talk you through them slowly. So it starts with this nice wee bend at the 10th fret again on the G string up to the 14th. And we're barring this 10th fret on the B string and 10th fret on the high E string. And I'm playing thumb and then thumb on the B string and then index finger on the high E string. And I'm going to do a pull off between 13 and 10 and then thumb on the 12th fret of the G string. Making those notes nice and sharp and quite snappy with the fingers. So it may be worthwhile trying to pull the strings kind of away from the guitar rather than getting that snappy noise. Then we're going to pull 12, 10 on the G down to the 12th fret on the D string. So that's your kind of first part. Second part, and then the third part, 10, 12 on the D string, and then 10, 10 on the G and B strings, and you're just playing straight up a D minor chord there, and finishing on the 12th fret of the G string. It's a great wee look. Love it. And then we're going to do a wee walk up before the kind of famous arpeggio bit at the end. We're going to walk up with the notes. So we're going to walk up 10 to 11. And then we're going to bend 13 up to 15. And then while that's bent, play 13 on the high E string underneath it and then let the bend back down. And then play the high E string on the 10th fret. But before each of those notes at the start, we've got a couple of those wee percussive notes. So I'm playing these on the G string. And I do thumb, index, and then I reveal that B string note. And it's a nice wee percussive effect to add just in before you reveal the notes. It's got a wee bit more of a flavour rather than just going having those wee notes in there. What? And then we move into the arpeggio bit at the end where you've got a D minor arpeggio and a B flat arpeggio. A C major arpeggio. So he's just playing directly over the top of the chords here. The arpeggios are 13, 10 on the high E string, and then 10 on the B string, and then 10 on the high E string. So that's the order of notes. And then B flat, you just move the B string note up one fret to the 11th fret, keep the other two the same. And then C major, just move that whole ensemble of notes up two frets, and you get 15, 12, 13. Cool. And how I'm playing that is I'm picking the first note with a down strum, well, a down thumb on the high E string at the 13th. And that's a pull off. So that's a thumb. And then I'm going on to the B string with a thumb again. And I'm re-picking the high E note on the 10th fret with the index finger. And that sets me up to get back into the 13th fret with the thumb again. So it's thumb, pull off, thumb, index. Thumb, pull off, thumb, index. Got a big blister on my thumb now. So I play that much better on the intro video than I did there. But that's the mechanic of that anyway. That's how you would get round that. It's just a worthwhile kind of try to build up this callus that I clearly haven't got yet. And then you're just tagging off with a second position D minor. So it's kind of reminiscent of the very first phrase that you played. So it's that kind of thing, but just up an octave on the high E string. Between the 15th and 13th frets. And just coming back down into position one. So there's some nice wee licks in there. It's really kind of good to kind of, rather than sitting, if you can be bothered to learn full solos, that's ideal. But it might be just be worthwhile to steal just one or two wee ideas like these, just to get from one position to the other. So that's you back into this, that D minor there. So you can take these. And it gets you from one area of the neck here, down there. These ideas. Are really kind of nice for stealing. They're really good for kind of building up a good bit of strength and making sure that you're kind of bending. Making sure you're kind of bending's in tune. Percussive notes in. I clearly don't play as much fingerstyle as I should, because some of these wee ideas are pretty cool, and it'd be nice to kind of see if we can maybe squeeze some of these ideas in with that. Like, instead of doing the thumb and the index, because I'm more of a pick player, obviously. Instead of doing the down strum with the thumb and then the index and then catching the notes, you can maybe try that with a pick. That might be worth experimenting with. I've never tried that before. But at least it'll give my blistery thumb a break for the night anyway. But I hope there was some nice ideas in there worth stealing. You don't need to learn the whole thing note for note. You can just do what I do and bash along with it until it sounds semi-right. Anyway, I'm going to do some more dissections of some solos in the next couple of weeks. If you'd like to hear anything, give me a shout. If you can, you can head over to my YouTube page, YouTube at markbutt.guitar. You can do a wee subscribe in there. There's going to be more videos and stuff going up there. I've also started a website called markbuttguitar.com where there's going to be PDFs and photos and a lot more videos getting put on there. There's also the option for live streaming on the site, so I'll be doing monthly live streams where you can kind of log on and ask some questions and get a kind of free monthly chat and a monthly lesson. There's a members group and all that kind of stuff as well. It's all just kind of very new at the moment, so there's not a lot of stuff on there at the minute. But I'm going to be building that up over the next few weeks. So I'm available for online lessons via Zoom. That seems to be the big platform at the moment. So hit me up there if you'd like to get some lessons booked. And by all means, kind of like this, share it far and wide, and let other people know if they're interested in lessons to give me a wee shout, and I'll be happy to help you out. So thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all at a different time. Bye now.